talk a little bit about faith slash prayer.
I like that.
What is faith?
Believe.
Things heard about but not seen. Mm-hmm. So why do we believe in God? I want somebody in here to tell me, have you seen God in person?
No.
But we believe in Him and we love Him and we trust in Him.
Amen. Amen.
Yes.
Hallelujah. And every time we need, we're quick to go to Him.
All right.
Yes, we are.
And I've really been, I'll be honest with you, I'm not going to go into it, but Carol will tell you, I've really been bummed out about this life. And I'll probably stay bummed out for a good while. A lot of times, I'm guilty of this. You pray and you pray and you pray and you pray about something, and I'm sure we've all been there. And either we don't get any results, we think, or we get the results that God wants us to have, and not what we want. And that's not always to our best too. I don't know anything. I'm 75 years old. I don't know anything in my lifetime that I love more or believe in more than King Jesus Christ.
Amen. Amen.
I've shared before with you, Pastor Cockle and I have talked about that. And I sure haven't lived at the foot of the cross in my life. I've done things that I wish they could change or go back and do over. And I think most of us in our lifetime would probably say that.
Sure.
But even as a young boy, and I can't explain this other than my two grandmothers and my mother always teaching me about God. But even as a little boy, I felt His presence. And how many times He's kept me out of problems, out of bad situations. And I never did drink, never did smoke, never did do those things. But we all, one way or the other, had ghosts in our closet that we wish we didn't have. Sometimes faith can be tricky.
Yes.
Faith can come in different levels for all of us. We're all different. Mm-hmm. But when we live for Him, we're all the same in His eyes. When we called Pastor Conklin for prayer for us, our loved ones, our sons and daughters, etc., etc., why did we call them? A couple of reasons. Number one, we believe in Him. He's proved Himself time and time and time again to all of us.
Amen.
He stays here, him and Sister Conklin, that a lot of people wouldn't. You look at their bank account's not running over. Look around. Look at all the empty pews. But when we call on him, my son or daughter, whatever it might be, we believe in it, and we have faith that He can reach heaven.
Sure.
And probably everyone in here today, including me and my family, He has knocked on the door of heaven, and guess what happened? The door was opened for us.
Amen.
Thanks to Him. Thanks to His loyalty to Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Thanks to His loyalty to this church and and each one of us and our families. I have no doubt, and I've done it many times, I have no doubt when I ask Pastor Conklin to pray for my son, my daughter, my grandson, my great-grandson, my brother, it's none. I don't have to call him today or tonight and ask him to do that. You don't either. And call him tomorrow to make sure he did it. Or call him tomorrow and say, Pastor, I want you to pray for such and such. It's done. And it's not done with him just one time.
Right.
Look around. We all can say the same thing. Prayer. And buddy, am I guilty of this? A lot of times, and it's easier during the day because they're up and about. A lot of times at night, I don't want to go in there and live in the room and kneel down and pray. I'll just pray right here in bed. Or I might be in my recliner watching TV. Well, I'll turn it off and I'll pray.
Right.
Now, there's nothing wrong with that. I'm not saying that. Now, I've got to be careful about praying when I'm in my truck because all the idiots out there that rings my bell. But the point I'm trying to make, if we really need God right now, guess where we go? Like the camel, we get on our knees for me. But the camel does, when he takes on cargo, and when he makes cargo off, he gets back on his knees. A buddy will get on our knees. We're wearing out. We'll go out to Dallas or Dick's to get us some knee pads. We'll find somebody that works in the coal mine, like you know what I'm talking about, to get the coal miner's knee pads. But we'll wear them out. And then, as Pastor reaches heaven for us, we put the knee pad up and we start praying in bed again. Now, I love this and you do too. I believe this with all my heart. If you really have a need, that can be today, tonight, tomorrow, whatever. You'll come closer of having that need met by God when you get on your knees.
Amen, amen.
I know that, and I think everybody in here knows that. And not only getting on your knees, we don't pray with our lips. We pray with our heart. And our belief and trust in Him. And going back, our faith in Him. And I've said this many times before, and I know Pastor. God is not on our timetable. We're on Him. And if we keep praying, and we keep holding on, and we keep trusting, He will answer our prayers.
Yes, He will. Amen.
And it might not be the way we want, but Carol's always schooled me on that. He'll answer because He knows what's best for us.
Amen.
Today, tomorrow, the rest of our life. And I want Pastor and Mr. Conklin to know that I love them with all my heart. And that ain't just lip service. That's right here. I tell my two great-grandsons, I love you. Now they're going. Every morning. I don't know about every morning, but most mornings. I'll say, hey guys, where's Jesus live? They'll put up their little hands and point up to heaven.
Praise
and I'll talk to Jesus briefly. be forgiven and forgiven.
Praise God.
Amen.
That's good.
Real good, thank you.
I got a cross, and Carol does, and some of you might have. And I hang it on my mirror in my truck. And I got a New Testament, and I put it on the cut place in my desk. You know, we can witness in a lot of different ways. But I think every time I'm at Walmart or Delta Mall or Kroger's or wherever it might be, everybody that walks by my truck, most of them, you know, will look in. You look in, we look in. And they see that cross. And guess what else? She put it on there for me. I really didn't like it. I said, that makes me look like a sissy. It's white. It's a white ribbon. And you know, hit me. That's what Jesus is. He's white, pure as snow.
Yes, he is.
Now, I don't know if people see that and realize that. It even took me. I was trying to get her to take it off. It made me realize that's what it's all about. That's a witness about every single word, probably more than I could ever do with my lips.
Amen.
Pray with your heart.
Hallelujah.
And as Pastor says, pray in the Spirit.
Yes.
And Pastor, Sister Conklin, not only do I love you, I believe in you, I trust in you, and I'm so thankful to God that you're here.
Yes.
Because every time Pastor said back door, that's the front door. Every time I come through that front door, and every time I go back out that front door, I feel a lot better than when I come in.
Now,
that says a lot for them. That says a lot for us, and that says a lot for our church. I hope I've made some points about faith and praying. They go hand in hand. You can't have one without the other. And then you add love to that. And that's what our Lord Jesus Christ is all about.
Amen.
Every time I watch it, the film, when he was crucified, I can't watch it all. When they start ripping his skin off and stuff, I got to go. He did that for us.
Yes, he did.
Yes, he did.
He didn't charge us a penny.
No, he didn't.
We didn't have to give him food stamps, green stamps. We didn't have to give him anything.
It all for us.
Now, he wants us to give him our soul, but he don't make it. Give us something about that, and I promise I'll shut up. He gave us a choice. We don't have to live for him. We can go out in the world. We can get drunk and smoke dope and pop pills and all that other stuff. And to be quite honest with you, that's a lot easier living for him. But I got this for you. So the rewards are so much greater.
Yeah. Amen. When we do live
for him.
When they lay us in that box, as soon as we die, it's over as far as changing, going back and redoing things, making things right. It's over. As soon as we die, we're going to one or two places. And there's no in between. As Christians, as lovers of Christ Jesus, and as believers in him, all of us, every day of our lives from here on, we need to be all that we can be for him in every way. Now, we all know life is tough. And I'm afraid that life will be a lot tougher.
Yes, it is.
But it really doesn't matter if we lay down at night and put your head on that pillow and you don't have to worry about waking up in the morning, because if you don't wake up, you're going to be in the greatest home ever known to mankind.
Hallelujah.
Heaven. you don't have to. We all pay utility bills. You don't want to get them paid, put it right in the mail.
Amen.
I think they sit around watching, and as soon as you pay, they kick it in your mailbox. We don't have to worry about that. We don't have to worry about house payment, insurance payment. So guess what? The day that he went on that cross, for all of us, all of that was taken care of.
Praise God.
There's no real estate tax in heaven. No home insurance in heaven.
Amen.
He's our insurance.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
He's our tax collector.
Yes, he is. Hallelujah.
I want you to know I love y'all, and you all meaningful in my life. I know me and Nancy would sit back there and we'd get each other. Brother Walker, Brother Fred. They're going to be gone for a while. And then we'll go slide into their slot. I'm almost there. That's just life. But the greatest prize of all is our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.